Pretty exciting. Some Chicago public school students are hoping to become the next generation of tech leaders.
The Taft High School robotics team designed a machine that could shoot a basketball and now is taking aim on international competition in the First Robotics Championship in Houston. WGN's Mike Lowe has their story.
At Taft High School in Norwood Park on Chicago's northwest side,
I think my halls are like a little angled.
Inside of a classroom, these science students aren't wasting time. But they are monkeying around.
Googly eyes of terror right here.
This is Monkey. The creation of the school's robotics team, known as the Robotic Eagles.
What we have standing behind me is about 150-pound robot that is competing in the first robotics competition.
Science teacher Tony Schmidt, his team of students, and the googly-eyed, mustached monkey are heading to the first robotics championship competition in Houston to test their mettle against 500 teams from around the world, an event that combines the excitement of sports with the rigors of academics.
We're really excited to be going.
The Taft team won this year's Midwest Regional competition.
I was crying in tears when I found out we were going to Texas.
This year's teams were required to develop and build robots around a theme: transportation and delivery. The robots have to carry cargo and climb equipment. Monkey can pick up and shoot a ball.
The balls are called cargo, and your goal is to score them in a lower goal or a higher goal. Our robot uses vision targeting to actually shoot the balls up at the high goal. And then at the end of it, it moves to the hangar zone and it's able to climb to the mid bar.
Metal gymnastics.
It made the mid bar.
And mental gymnastics, a sport for the mind that requires innovation, creativity, and problem solving skills.
I came in basically not knowing anything. We did tool training in the beginning of the year, which helped us like figure out how to use the different types of tools.
The ball went through the conveyor system with the pulleys, and that's what brings it up to the shooter so it can shoot the balls.
Over the course of 6 weeks, the team refined its design and its strategy, collaborating with Mr. Schmidt.
With a lot of new improvements, we were able to add more supports, and we came together to see what we could improve on our robot, and then we won UIC, and then now we're going to Texas.
The teams are limited to certain materials like metal, aluminum, and wood. They also use gears, gyroscopes, rotors, and motors from a standardized kit.
The main part of the robot is EcoBoard. The base of the robot is metal. There's a lot of wiring and stuff that goes into it as well.
The Taft team says the first competition, which stands for Inspiration and Recognition of Science and Technology, does just that, inspiring students to take on technical challenges as a team.
We're a really close team and we work so hard together, and I love them all. They're the best.
In Norwood Park, Mike Lowe, WGN News.
Pretty impressive. Robotics teams can spend up to $30,000 a year on materials, equipment, and travel. The Taft team is trying to raise $25,000 to send 15 members of the team to the competition in Houston.
What a future I'm sure they're going to have here. We've got a link to their fundraising page. You'll find it on our website, WGNTV.com.